Now that we know we should be tofu, let's explore the actual code that drives this application. Let yourself marinate in it as we go through, like tofu in sauce or something. Now, as we go through, think not only of how the code works, but how different changes would affect the behavior of the application. By constantly thinking about how we could change the application or break the application in different ways, it'll let us start thinking more like the original developer was thinking. So let's explore. First, we have index.html. At the very bottom, we have all of our script tags here. One thing you might notice is of all of these custom script tags here, they run in a particular order. Our model, todo.js, runs first, then our collection, then both of our views, then our router, then our app. Now, a lot of times, the order of all of this does matter. My intuition tells me that the reason app.js is last is that it gives all of the other files a chance to get set up before the app actually gets kicked off with this line here. So let's see if that's true. Let's take a look at our model. Now there's a particular pattern that we're going to see again and again with these files. Var app equals app or an empty object, meaning if app exists, don't do anything. If app doesn't exist, set app equal to a new empty object. So whichever one of these is first, there won't be an app variable and it'll get set to an empty object. And then we have the module pattern, an iffy, immediately invoked function expression. So we have an open parentheses, a function, a bunch of code here, close parentheses, and then we run it immediately. This function here is not named, doesn't have a name. It's an anonymous function, and it's wrapped in parentheses here and immediately invoked. What that means is any variables that we declare inside of this function don't pollute the global scope. They don't go up onto the window object, meaning they don't accidentally overwrite any variables that may already exist. And we can see that inside of this function, we've got app.todo equals something. In this case, a backbone.model.extend, and we pass it an object literal. And that goes all the way down to here. Or at a higher level, app.todo equals this thing. Let's take a look at our collections, todo.js. We have the same pattern. Var app equals app or an empty object. Then we have an iffy, an immediately invoked function expression. And down here we say var todos equals this backbone collection. At the very bottom we say app.todos equals a new todos. Now, don't get mired in the details of what's going on here. Just look at the big picture. We're creating an app object literal, and then we're saying app.todos equals some stuff, or app.todo equals some stuff. If we look at the routers, same thing. App equals app or an empty object. If we scroll down, app.todo router equals some stuff. Both of our views do the same exact thing. App equals app or an empty object. App.appView equals some stuff. In this case, app.todoView equals some stuff. So as all of these files run, it creates an object with all of these various properties on it. ToDoView, AppView, our router, our model, our collection. And finally, at the very end, app.js runs. So what happens there? Well, we say jQuery in this case. So when the document is loaded, run this following function. New app.appView. Now, why exactly that works, I'm not sure right now because I haven't looked at the documentation and figured out how we kick off a backbone app. But I do know that the reason that these are first is so that way that app object can get set up. Now, we should have some idea of where the various functionality lives because of our previous experience with other organizational paradigms. Our views are the stuff that the user sees and the stuff the user interacts with. Our router is just like the view except for the URL bar. We've got the model, which is todo.js, and we've got a collection, which is a collection of models for all of our various to-dos. And then app.js, right in this line, kicks it all off. Let's take a look at index.html. The other thing that we previously saw was all of these bizarre script tags with type equals text slash template. And that's a chunk of HTML, which is a template for something that may repeat or be some kind of a dynamic view. Here, for example, we've got the view for the items. Now in the next video, we're going to make some modifications to this code base here.